Danielle with the Sweeney Agency, and I'm very pleased to be here this evening with Dr. Mark DeVolder, one of the country's most requested speakers on change and change management. His inspiring presentations show leaders how to create cultures that embrace innovative disruption, encourage resilience, and empower people to accept change as opportunity. Mark, thank you so much for joining us tonight. So Mark, with all the information you've given us about learning to accept change, adapting and anticipating change, what are the key questions that we can be asking ourselves right now?
Well, I want to answer that question, but before I do, let me tell you the questions we shouldn't be asking.
Great.
The questions we shouldn't be asking right now, and I'll qualify this, the questions we shouldn't be asking and fixating on. These are also questions that everybody is asking and wants to know the answers to. And those are the questions of how long will we be like this? When will this be over? And when can we get back to normal? Those kind of questions. I mean, it's heart-wrenching. I'm asking them. Many other people are asking those kind of questions. But if we fixate on the how long and getting back to normal, what that really shows is that we're stuck, that we actually are not accepting the change, that it's still very, very difficult for us, and we're not prepared. So remember, we are in a transition. And when we're in a transitional time, that means that back is no longer there. We have now and we have the future, and we don't know exactly what the future will look like. We better start anticipating, but we have to start doing preparation inside with ourselves. So how do we prepare for the future? I think the first thing that we need to do is look at what kind of changes, what kind of personal changes we need to go through. And that's going to involve a transformation. Transformation always occurs in isolation. Sorry for the bad news, because people are reacting to being in isolation. But it's actually absolutely necessary. The time of transformation happens in isolation. Reminds me of some of the early work that was done on transitions by a fellow by the name of Victor Turner. He was an anthropologist who visited different tribal societies and studied, among other things, the initiation rites in each tribal society. How a boy became a man, or how a girl became a woman. That just didn't happen, but it happened in a transition. And what he found is that with each different society that he was in, the practices were almost the same. What they would do is they would take a boy and separate them from everyone else, put them in isolation for a week, a month, maybe longer. And during that time of isolation, they experience loneliness, hardship, even pain. But when that period of time was over and they reemerged, when they went back to the group, they came back different. The boy had become a man. Isolation is the key, because isolation is where the work of transformation occurs. So, now to your question, finally. What kind of questions should we be asking ourselves during this time? I would say the first question is, ask yourself, what am I resisting right now? During this time, am I resisting reinvention, reinventing myself? You know, many of us like who we are, we're comfortable with the way things are. Unfortunately, we have to change because the situation is changing. So ask yourself, am I resisting reinvention? Am I resisting disruption? Am I resisting technology? All of us have been pushed to adapt more quickly with technology. Maybe some would be resisting trying new things for fear of failure. So we ask ourselves, what am I resisting? Secondly, in this time, in isolation, what do I need to be learning? What new skills? Because these are skills not to that when we go back, but these are new skills as we walk into a new future. What new products and services could I deliver? What new delivery methods could I offer? Will I be able to work remotely, virtual meetings, and have face-to-face meetings? Will I be able to do both? Will I be savvy enough to carry both of those off? And then lastly, we need to ask ourselves, okay, in this time, how will I be different? I think the kind of things that people will say during this is, I've become a learner. I've become a risk taker. I've learned to collaborate in new ways with people, remotely and in person. And I've learned to adapt and anticipate. And the reaction to all of these things is in our control.